real quiet and watch up on the screen.
If you see a fireman that helps you, if you have a cat, get your cat down from a tree, you say that you can get your cat down from that tree.
When my mom and dad help me.
Good day, you're really good job reading my book. Thank you, you're welcome.
Yeah, no.
Yes? Well, I'm going to give you some homework, okay? The
The teachers should have collected some books and activity books that are at the front desk for you. But this is what we're going to do for homework. Who can tell me what this is?
Dinner bell!
The dinner bell, Chief.
Tells me when Mrs. Chief's done cooking and it's time to eat. I hear that, she's going to say, dinner!
And you eat it?
I got to. I haven't turned down too many.
I guess not. Boys and girls, what is this? It's a fire alarm, a smoke detector. And what it does all day is it sits on the wall or the ceiling and it just smells. And what's it do when it finds or smells smoke to let you know that you're in danger? It beeps, okay? So, the first part, what's the matter, Chief?
That made me hungry.
Made you hungry? It's not dinner time yet.
No.
Just have to hold on, Chief. Okay, it's not a dinner bell like Chief Durog said. It's a smoke detector. And it alerts you when there's danger in the house. Your first part of your homework is have mom and dad check all the smoke detectors in the house. Make sure they beep. But, like Chief said, this is Halloween, so some people like decorating for Halloween. Then comes Thanksgiving. People decorate. My wife likes putting out candles. And then after Thanksgiving, we have that holiday with that, that big guy in the red suit with the beard guns, possibly Santa Claus. And we put up Christmas trees and other kind of lights. So now is a good time, boys and girls, mom and dads, to go ahead and replace the battery in your smoke detectors if they're not hardwired. So make sure you've got a good battery and make sure that the smoke detector works. Okay? Tell your mom and dads if you don't have a smoke detector, Rochester Fire Department has it, but I can only give them out to moms and dads. So if you're in need of a smoke detector, please contact Rochester Fire and we'll make sure you have a smoke detector for your house.
Good.
Okay? Sound good, Chief? You agree with that? Okay, so first thing we're gonna do is check our smoke detectors. Now let's get back to this fire drill. At school, when you guys do a fire drill, everyone gets quiet, you stand up, you go to the door, you line up, you listen for instructions, the teacher takes you down the hallway, you go outside, and each classroom has a special spot they go to outside when you line up, correct?
Yeah.
And the teacher counts 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, make sure that she has all the kids.
What if there's more than 8 kids? Shouldn't she count higher?
She should. I'm pretending we have.
I don't want to be just.
It's a small class.
Small classes, yeah, I can see.
Okay.
There's some classes that have more than 8.
If there's more than 8,
I think we need to work with the teachers on their calendar.
Okay.
I'll be able to tutor afterwards.
Okay. Teachers, you heard that. Chief Durong will help you count past 8 after school today.
I can take you to 11.
All right. All right. Thank you, Chief. Now, please, let me get out with this.
So
you're outside, and you're in a special meeting spot, and you need to count. Now, at home, I want things to be done a little different, because where does fire go, or where does smoke go when there's a fire? The smoke goes up. So what Sparky's telling you is where do boys and girls need to go? And in just a minute, I'm going to have Fireman Dan put on all his gear, and he's going to show you what a fireman looks like. But even with all our special gear on, we still crawling, because that's the safe zone. That's where it's the coolest, that's where the best air is. Okay, so we're going to crawl. So your smoke detector goes off at night, you're going to roll out of bed, you're going to crawl over to your door. Do we just open our door?
Why, sure. Turn it off.
No, Chief. Could the fire be outside? And what happens if we open the door?
We gotta look!
How do we know if the fire's on the outside? You feel it, Chief. Feel the door. Not with your tongue, Chief.
I tell the coffee's too hot, the soup's too hot.
Okay, first of all, Chief, you would be down low.
Down low.
Hands and knees.
Hands and knees.
Okay, now check the door.
Feel in the door. Feels like wood.
The back of your hand, Chief, like Sparky's telling you.
Why am I using the back of my hand?
Okay, is it hot?
Okay, I'm going to say yes, it's hot.
Okay, so
now, I'm not even going to go. What do I do now?
If the door's hot, do we open it, boys and girls?
And how am I getting out?
How's he going to get out, boys and girls? The window. You're going to go to the window. Okay, now how many of us live upstairs? How many have... Now, if we open the window, can we just jump out?
No!
Okay. What do I have on my fire truck that I can get you with? Got it.
A lasso.
A lasso? How's that going to work, Chief?
No, I thought that's what you said, a lasso.
A ladder.
Ladder. That makes sense.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. So, we've talked about we're going to have Mom and Dad change the batteries. We're going to check the smoke detectors. And then I want you guys to do a fire drill at home. I want you to practice. Have Mom and Dad make the smoke detector go off when you're in your bedroom. Then I want you to roll out of bed. I want you to crawl on your hands and knees. I want you to check your door. I want you then to open the door, crawl down the hallway, go outside, go out the front door or the back door, whatever is closest to your bedroom.
Okay.
And then just like in school, you guys have a special meeting spot. You need a special meeting spot at home.
Yeah, mine's a Dairy Queen.
And Derek, Chief, you live 6 miles out of town.
6 miles out, but it's our meeting place. I'll put some maple on my name.
At 2 o'clock in the morning, Chief. You're
sure good. Is. First in line.
They're not open, Chief.
I know. That's why it makes me first in line.
But then if the fire department shows up, how do we know that you're not still in your house?
Check the Dairy Queen.
Okay, boys and girls, we're not going to do that. What I want you to do at home is to go to the special meeting spot. So at my house, if the smoke detector goes off, I get on my hands and knees. My wife and I, we crawl up the front door. My son comes down the stairs from upstairs. Now he might go out the back door because it's closer, but then he's going to go around the front of the house and we're going to meet across the street at a tree. So your special meeting spot could be the mailbox, could be a lamppost, could be a tree, could be the neighbor's front porch. Doesn't make a difference, but everyone has to know what the special meeting spot is. Now, kids, can I talk to the parents for a minute? Okay, I need you to be. Okay, parents, when you do your fire drill tonight, do it once when everyone's awake and plan it and make sure that they're crawling out and they're doing things right and they know the special meeting spot. But once they go to sleep, they've been asleep for a while, go ahead and activate your smoke detector and you might find out that the smoke detector isn't gonna wake up most of the kids. An alarm clock won't wake them up. So now, parents, when you do your fire escape plan, you need to plan how you're going to get your kids out as well as yourself out. And at 2 o'clock in the morning, it's not the time to try to figure out how I'm going to get from my bedroom to my kids' bedroom and how I'm going to get them safely outside. Just like the fire department, we train on how to go in and how to execute to put out a fire. At 2 o'clock in the morning, you're not thinking straight. You're already scared because your smoke alarm's going off. So practice with the kids, but then practice with yourself and whoever else adults you have in the house to think of how I'm going to get my kids out as well as myself out and be safe about it, okay? Very important. All right, kids, I'm back to you. Okay, so smoke detector, batteries, fire drill at home, very important. Now, I mentioned that the firemen, I'm telling you to get out. Now, once we're outside at our special meeting spot, I just remember, my puppy's inside. Can I go back in and get my puppy?
No!
Whose job is that? Okay, so repeat this after me because this is pretty important too. Once we are out, we stay out. So once you're out, you what?
Stay out!
Very good, very good. And Fireman Dan. He's going to show you what a fireman looks like when we go in to fight fire. Does anyone in the audience know this guy? Someone. You do? Oh, there he is. Does everyone know Ryan? Not only is this fireman Dan, what do you call him?
My dad.
His dad. It's kind of special.
Yeah, but tell him who you're named after.
My dad.
Okay, we have another fireman named Ryan Murphy, but today we have Chief Dewrock. Okay, so like I said, firemen, we're going to crawl in. So on our boots we have grippers on our toes, He's got special knee pads to kind of protect us and so we don't rip the pants. Now he puts on a jacket. Now this is a special type of clothing. If fire falls on this, it's going to burn, but as soon as we brush it off or it falls off, the fire is going to go out and it won't continue to burn. Now if fire falls on Chief Durong's shirt, is it going to continue to burn?
Yeah!
Okay. And we're going to talk about what to do with that here in a little bit. Okay, so like I said, this is special material that won't burn unless the fire's directly on it. Now we have, what do we use to put fire out?
Dirt!
Dirt. Dirt would work, Chief, but what do I have on my fire truck? Water. And when it's raining outside, you guys will wear a raincoat. Well, inside our fire gear, this white part is a raincoat. It keeps us kind of dry because if we get super wet, and then we're the room was to go ahead and flash to get super hot, we could get steam burned inside our gear. So someone's thought about safety for the fire gear. And then this last part is an insulation that helps keep us cool because when we go into a house that's on fire, the whole house can get hotter than the inside of mom's oven when she's making chocolate chip cookies. It can get almost 3 or 4 times as hot. So we have to make sure we stay kind of cool. So that kind of protects us. It does protect us. Now he's going to put on this mask, but is this a scary Halloween mask?
No!
I think he looks better with it on.
Does he look better with it on, Ryan?
No!
No. All right. So you're gonna, what this does is it keeps the smoke out of his nose and his eyes, and he's gonna hook up a hose off the backpack he's gonna put on and helps him breathe. So just like you guys carry a book bag, we have a backpack, but only instead of books, we have air inside of this.
Can he go underwater with that?
No, this isn't the type that you can go underwater with.
Can you go spear fishing?
No, that's scuba diving. This is not quite the same. Almost, Chief.
It looks like it.
It does. It does look like it.
It looks like a scuba.
Okay. And now he's going to put on his helmet. Why do we wear a helmet? So our head doesn't burn. But sometimes in a fire, if the ceiling's on fire, things start dropping and hit us in the head. And then if you notice the back part, even the Chief Durong, the long part's in the back because we spray water and that keeps the water from going down the back of our necks and getting us all wet and up. Now we're going to put gloves on. Now, excuse me. He's going to be completely covered up and then he's going to hook up the air to his mask. You'll be able to hear him breathe in a minute. But do you guys see any bare skin? Is he completely covered and protected?
Yeah.
Okay, now you can listen to him breathe. Stand next to him, Ryan. Or Chief Durong.
What? Can you say, Duke, I am your father?
He does kind of sound like Darth Vader, but is it a scary guy?
Cool?
No, he's a friendly fireman. And then when he gets out of the truck, okay,
sorry.
Thanks, Chief. I really did try leaving him at the station this time. Okay, then Dan's going to get down with his partner. They're going to grab the hose off the truck, and then we're going to crawl into the house, just like I'm telling you to crawl out. Because, once again, that's our safe zone. Thank you, Dan. Okay. Now, there's sometimes you guys have the decision whether to do the right thing or not. Want to help me? Yeah. Okay. You ready? 1, 2, 3! That's quite a joke. Okay, sit down. Okay. What's your name?
Everybody wants to.
Caden? All right, my name's Tom. Nice to meet you. Let's pretend.
Katie!
Please do all that you do. Be polite. Be polite.
That was being polite. You've been to ZebraZone before. You know about politeness.
Yes.
Okay, but let's not interrupt them. That was part of it.
Yeah, I did.
All right. Okay. So let's pretend you and I are BFFs. Okay. Okay. Now, do you like going to Manitow Mountain? You don't know that place.
A little park.
Huh? Okay. Whoa. Boy, you're ruining my skip. Do you like going out to the playground? Okay. Do you like going down the slide? So do I. So let's pretend that you and I are playing on the slide at recess because we're BFFs and everything like that, right? And let's say I go down the slide and underneath the dirt, I say, oh, look what I found.
What?
What should we do with this? Don't mess.
Throw it on the floor.
No, right, don't mess with it, so I dropped it. Okay, so we should mess with this. What is this? A lighter. Okay, but because you know what to do right, and I didn't really tell you what my pretend BFF name is. My name is Terrible Tom. So you tell me not to mess with it. We probably should tell a teacher, right? But I say, I'm going to go in the corner, and I'm going to play with it. And then I play with it, and my clothes catch on fire. You're right. I made the mistake by not, I wasn't supposed to play with it. And you did the right thing by telling someone, because sometimes your friends might forget to do the right thing. But you can say, don't touch it. I didn't listen. So I caught my clothes on fire. So what do I do now?
You're on fire?
I'm on fire.
I'm going to run in, head to the bathroom, turn on the faucet, and start throwing water on the where it's under burning. Water puts fire out. Run fast.
Okay, Chief, I think Chief Durong's wrong again, isn't he? Yeah. We don't run around. What was your answer? He's wrong. What's the right answer? Very good. Can you show me how to do that? Okay, we're going to show you guys how to do a good stop, drop, and roll. So let's pretend that I'm Trouble Tom, and I didn't listen to you, and I played with my lighter, and I caught you on fire. Show me how you're going to stop, drop, and roll.
Stop, drop, and roll.
Oh, well, keep rolling. Make sure you cover up your face. And then yell, help me, I'm on fire. Very good, very good. And good job. Okay, so we know we don't play with matches or lighters, or if we have a friend that finds one, we try to tell them to do the right thing, because that's part of a character thing, isn't it? Okay. Now, one thing, did I mention my phone number?
No.
Okay. Okay. All right, you guys have practiced that, so in the middle of the night, if the smoke detector goes off or we go outside for a special meeting spot and we're all there, I call the fire department by... Okay, now let's say that I need a policeman because there's stranger danger in the area and I'm scared. How do I get a hold of a policeman? Okay, I'm home with just mom. And she's carrying a laundry basket downstairs, and she trips, falls, and bumps her head, and I can't wake her up, and I need the ambulance. Who do I call? Okay, I wake up in the morning, I get my bowl of Captain Crunch, I go to the refrigerator, and there's no milk. Who do I call?
No.
911. No, we don't call 911. We probably yell for mom. And then mom yells at dad because he didn't bring it home the night before when he came home from work. That's the way it works in my house. Okay, but 911 is not a toy. 911 is just for fire, police, and ambulance, okay? All right. Can you guys think of anything? One more thing. What's probably, where's the one room in the house that is probably the most dangerous for boys and girls?
My bedroom's the most dangerous.
Okay, wait a second, boys and girls.
It's a bedroom.
How is that the most dangerous? You have a nice big bed, you can lay down, you can rest.
Yes, I love doing that, but when I get out in the middle of the night, I have a dog that lays down on the floor, I trip over it, and then I fall and, you know, pull muscles. It's dangerous in there.
I can see that. Maybe you ought to turn the light on so you can see the dog, so you can step over the dog. Because Sparky doesn't like being kicked.
Well, I never thought of that. Sorry, Spark.
All right. Okay, boys and girls, what's the most dangerous for all of you? You don't know? Where? I heard it. The kitchen. Okay, the kitchen, because we have a stove. Can the stove burn us even if it's electric?
Yes.
Do I need fire to get burned? If mom's cooking on the stove and it's getting close to dinner time and she gets a phone call and she answers it, can I reach up and grab that pot? Can the hot spaghetti sauce burn me? Yes. Can something on the microwave burn us? So we don't play in the kitchen at all ever, do we?
Nope.
All right. Okay. Well, boys and girls, I think about that's about all I have. Please go home and do your homework. Your teacher should have hooked up some books I dropped off earlier at the office. And inside that book will remind you to check your smoke detectors, to do a good fire drill at home. We don't play with matches and lighters. It talks about stop, drop, and roll. It reminds you that we should never play in the kitchen. Okay? Okay, now tonight is Rochester High School's football team's traveling to Whitco. So on the count of three, I want you guys to yell, "Go Zebras!" so loud that the football team can hear you at the high school, but more important, I want Whitco to hear you, so they start shaking in their boots knowing that ZebraZone is behind our Zebras tonight, okay? Okay, on three. One, two, three. All right, thank you. You guys have a great weekend and a great fall break. See you next year.
Are you going to be okay with coming to Walmart with me to pick out a bike next week?
Yeah.
Will that be good? Okay, good. Hopefully the weather will be nice so you can ride it over the break, right? Okay, give me a big round of applause. You want to give a high five to our two friends on the stage here? All right. Thank you, Mia. All right, good job, all of you guys. And remember, next month we'll have a new character trait to focus on. But remember, keep showing honor, okay? I'm very proud of you guys. Enjoy the last song, okay? have one more thing that we want to do, and you have already been a part of it. Hold on, you need to have a seat for just another second. You helped make this big banner to show honor to our firefighters. Come on out, firefighters. Come on out. These guys are one of the bravest. These guys are just really brave, and they show a lot of courage. How many of you would like to run into a burning building? No way. Takes a lot of courage, doesn't it? And we need them to help keep us safe. So we made this big banner that says, "Thank you, firefighters. Columbia honors you." And you all signed your names to that. And we're going to give it to these firefighters because we appreciate them. So here's what I want you to do. I want you to give them a big round of applause. And I want you to scream as loud as you can.
Goodbye.